Hi, this is Michelle Barnacle again, and for this lesson we're going to be talking about perimeter and some of the properties of addition. When we talk about perimeter, we talk about geometric shapes, squares, rectangles, triangles, etc. And to find the perimeter, that means we are going to find the distance around the outside edges of whatever the shape may be. In the first example that you see, we're finding the perimeter of a triangle, and that means you have three different sides, 3, 4, and 5, and all you have to do is add those together to get 3 plus 5 makes 8, and then 8 plus 4 makes 12, so the perimeter of that triangle would be 12 centimeters. We are going to work this problem, which is installing a fence around a rectangular backyard. So I'm going to switch over so we can see the board. And whenever you're solving a word problem, it is really good to go ahead and draw a picture so that you can visually see the measurements that you're going to be using. So this is our rectangular backyard, and we have measurements of 91 feet long and 78 feet wide. So we want 91 feet long, 78 feet wide. And when we find the perimeter, all you have to do is add the sides together. In a rectangle, you need to know that opposite sides are equal. So if the bottom is 91 feet, then the top is also 91 feet. If the right-hand side is 78 feet, then the left-hand side is also 78 feet. So to find the perimeter, all you have to do is add all four sides together. So that would be P for perimeter is equal to 78 plus 91 plus 78 plus 91. And then you add the sides together. You can add two numbers at a time. It would make it easier for you. So when you add 78 plus 91, 8 plus 1 is in the ones column, that gives you 9. 7 plus 9 is 16, so that's 169 there. And if you have 169 here, and you're adding the same numbers together, you would also have 169 on this. And then to find the final perimeter, all you have to do is add those two groups together. So when we do that, I'm going to come over here, and that would be 169 plus 169. And when we add that, remember our rules for addition would be 9 plus 9 is 18. So we put the ones digit down, carry the tens digit, and then 6 plus 6 is 12, plus the one that we carried makes 13. So put the 3 down for the ones digit, carry the tens. And then that makes 1, 2, 300. Okay, so our final perimeter would be 338, and this is measured in feet, so you would always want to label your measurements, okay? So the perimeter would be 338 feet. Now, we are also going to talk about properties, and properties of addition are a few of them that are important. You have what's called the commutative property, and when you talk about commutative property, we talk about flip-flopping, changing the order of the numbers. So in the problem that you see, it says 2 plus 3 is equal to 3 plus 2. So if you know that 2 plus 3 is 5, then you also know that 3 plus 2 is 5. It does not matter the order that you add them in, you still get the same answer. Also, associative property, when you think of that, all you're doing is you are associating, talking to two people or two numbers associating together. In the first problem, the 3 and the 4 are grouped in parentheses, so those are the two that are talking together and they make 7, plus the outsider, which is 2, and that would make 9. When you look at the other side of the equation, it says 2 plus 3 would be in the parentheses. They are talking to each other. So that would be 2 plus 3 is 5, plus the outsider 4 would still make 9. So it does not matter the order that you add them in, you still get the same thing. Another property of addition is 0. Anytime that you have a number and you add nothing to it, you still have that number. And we call that the addition identity or the additive property of 0 because you are not changing the value of the number by adding 0 to it. So this last example says to name the different properties that we're talking about. In example A, you have the parentheses. The order of the numbers did not change, but the parentheses changed. First, the 2 and the 1 are grouped together, and then in the second side, the 3 and the 2 are grouped together. But if you notice, when you use parentheses, it doesn't matter, you still get the same value. But in parentheses, we are using the associative property of addition. In choice B, you have 3 plus 0 equals 3. That means that we did not change the value of the 3 that we started with. That is our property of 0. And the last one, 2 plus 1 is equal to 1 plus 2. That is commutative property because all we did was flip the numbers around. Okay? Now, that means that we are done with this part of the lesson. And I hope that you enjoyed it. And I look forward to talking to you for the next one.